First of all, I would like to thank the UNESCO for organizing this Olympiad, and I'm very happy to be here today and to be able to speak a word to all our international guests and our national guests, of course, the students, the teachers, and the supervisors. I'm working for the National Platform Science and Technology, which has been commissioned by the government, by the education, and the business sectors to ensure sufficient availability of people who have a background in scientific or technical education. And the aim is not just to make careers in science more appealing, but also to introduce educational innovations that inspire and challenges young people. And we try to ensure that the future supply of knowledge workers will meet the future demand as well. People who have a background in scientific or technical education are very crucial to society for developing new products, services, for social innovation, for social change also, and especially also on environmental and sustainability issues. Sufficient availability of these knowledge workers is also required for the Dutch government because they want to have a good competitive world position, and I guess that's the same for your countries as well. So if you come across a person who thinks science is not of many interests, tell them to think again. Science affects us all, every day of the year, from the moment we wake up, all day long and through the night. It's about your digital alarm clock, it's the weather report, the asphalt you drive on, the bus you ride in, your decision to eat a baked potato instead of fries, your cell phone, the antibiotics that treat your sore throat, clean water that you drink, and the light that you turn off when you go to sleep. They have all been brought to you by the courtesy of science. And the modern world would not be modern at all without the understandings of technology enabled by science. So it's very important what you all are doing today and already did in the weeks before this day. To make clear how deeply science is interwoven in our daily lives, just try imagining a day without scientific progress. No way to use electricity, no modern agriculture, and no modern medicine. But also clean air and drinking water, healthy biological food, and a variety of species are collective goods with an intrinsic value. However, it's also obvious that these resources become very scarce under the pressure of social, financial, and also demographic development. And this is why lasting care and attention is needed right now. The problems appear very clear, but the appropriate remedies are less so. And that is particularly the reason why you all thought about a solution in the form of a project designed from the perspective of particular disciplines, because healthcare, biology, physics, chemistry, or social science all can contribute to dilemmas of the better environment and sustainability. And the next coming days, and even today, you already gave us insight in new creative and innovative solutions on this. But I'm also proud that this UNESCO Olympiad is not only stimulating students to think about these issues and think about new solutions and environmental challenges, but it also is a good instrument to challenge students and to let them see that the sky really can be the limit. It's important to perform well and to appreciate and reward excellent achievements of the students. And this is the reason, among all the other things, that you as a contestant are fully in the spotlight today and will be in the next coming days. And you're already qualified in your own country, so you already met a lot of people who are interested in science. But here you have been able to meet students with the same interest as you have from all around the world. And I'd say use this unique opportunity to create contacts with people from your age group with the same interests in science. And it might well be the case that the contacts you created during this Olympiad form the basis on which you will be able to rely now, but even in the future and in your professional careers. Boys and girls, you have taken the first steps on the path of science, and in a very special way. Because it's about independently devising, creating, and executing a scientific research on a topic that is very important for for our future generations. I believe it's amazing that something like this is possible with so many young people from so many different countries. And what you did really shows talent, but also perseverance. Because doing your own research and managing your own project also means solving problems, working together with other people, being creative in searching new ways and solutions. I'm very impressed of what I saw today, because I'm one of the members of the jury, so I saw a lot of projects, and I'm very amazed. Very good. I congratulate you from this position, and I wish you good luck in the rest of your lives and your scientific careers. Thank you.